This episode of Funny Money is brought to you by John Cain's Physical Gold and Silver.
Now's the time! Go on in the waters! John Cain's here! You're here to tune in to Funny Money!
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
The world as we know it, it's gonna change. You might be saying to yourself, well, it started around March, right, John? And they had to shut everything down. And I would say no, it started long before that. The system came to an end in 2008, if you remember. We were just moments away from the ATMs not working.
We were a few days away from the ATMs not working.
See, the credit markets froze, but it took a little while to get there. See, in early 2007, they were saying, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine.
What is the worst case scenario if, in fact, we were to see prices come down substantially across the country?
Well, I guess I don't buy your premise. It's a pretty unlikely possibility.
Fuck you! You fucking knew! You fucking knew!
Well, let me play you this little piece of tape.
You can see some types of speculation, investors turning over condos quickly. So those sorts of things you see in some local areas. I'm hopeful that, and I'm confident, in fact, that the bank regulators will pay close attention to the kinds of loans that are being made, making sure that underwriting is done right. But I do think that this is mostly a localized problem and not something that's going to affect the national economy.
What do you think, what do you say when you hear that statement of yours from 2005?
Well, it was partly the result of the fact that I was representing the administration, and you don't really want to go out and say, you know, run for the hills, right?
Run to the hills.
And then what happened? We saw Bear Stearns first. They had a whole bunch of their fucking garbage. They were involved in all those subprime mortgages, and they fell. JPMorgan Chase got pennies on the dollar for Bear Stearns. Everything's fine, everything's fine, everything's fine, so it's fine, it's fine. And then Fannie and Freddie are next. And then the Secretary of the Treasury came in and he said,
these companies are so big and so interwoven into the financial markets and our financial system, we had no choice.
And then Lehman fell and they get it fucking taken over on a Sunday fucking night.
Where they gathered all the banks together like a fucking mafia. And they said, we're not gonna let Lehman fail. But I'm not bailing you out. The private sector has to.
And holy shit, the markets went down. And everyone's fucking freaking out. And I'm fucking trading. I'm going fucking. And they don't pass TARP. And then after TARP, the automotive industry needs a bailout. And then everything starts collapsing. And they need bailouts. And they start printing and printing and stimulus and more stimulus. And they papered over it. And everything was fucking great.
They not only kick the can down the road, they...
Let's go! Yeah! We won! We won!
You fucking did it.
What America does the best. Problem may come our way, but we always get through it. And it has nothing to do with the fact that the dollar is the world reserve currency and everyone's tied to us. It has to do with the great American exceptionalism.
And then we had the best unemployment record before in February of 2020. You can't live in fucking La La Land, ladies and gentlemen! There are consequences for your fucking actions! Cause what if the rest of the world say, fuck you, America, and do a bond sell-off? Then the Fed has to buy, and then they gotta monetize. And then next thing you know, you're spending $350 for a meal at Arby's!
We have the meat!
Arby's? Really? They survived this whole thing?
In March of 2020, we hit that fucking iceberg. Now it's coming apart, and they're not going to be able to piece that fucking ship together. We're going down,
baby. I'm not going to be left on the fucking sidelines while the whole fucking world burns around me, am I? I'm going to make some of that money.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
And you shouldn't feel guilty, and that's why you're tuned in to this guy, because you're there working every fucking day, aren't you? So while you're there working on Main Street, I'll be here to help you invest all your
money
on Wall Street.
On the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in and the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way. Working 9 to 5.